there, my name is Fawn. Come with me today to hike Mount Bromo in Indonesia. If you watch my video on the Ijen volcano, I visited Mount Bromo right after this hike. It's very common to visit Bromo and Ijen as part of a package tour. However, I decided to visit Bromo on my own. It gave me more flexibility and it ended up being completely free. If you want more flexibility and don't mind some hiking, I highly recommend going to Bromo on your own. However, if you want to give your legs a break, booking a tour is the way to go. All right, let's go. The easiest way to get to Mount Bromo is to first reach the town of Semoro Lawang. To reach this mountain town, first take a train to Probolinggo Station from wherever you are in Java. You can buy the train ticket easily using this app. Once you arrive at the train station, you can catch a bus to Semoro Lawang. I ended up booking a shared ride through Ijen Backpacker for around $13 from Banyuwangi to Semoro Lawang. Because Semoro Lawang is over 2,000 meters above sea level, it does get quite cold. I recommend bringing a headlight, a jacket, and good hiking shoes for this hike. From Semoro Lawang, my itinerary is to hike up to King Kong Hill to see Mount Bromo at sunrise, then head back to town for breakfast before hiking up to see the crater of Mount Bromo. During my dinner in town, I met two other hikers and we decided to go to Bromo together the next day. I went to sleep early and then started the hike at 3 a.m. It takes only about an hour and a half to reach the sunrise view at King Kong Hill. On the way, you will see many jeeps heading the same way, so you won't get lost. If you get tired at all at any point, there are plenty of people offering horse rides or motorbikes. After about an hour, you will reach the first official viewpoint. Feel free to stop here or continue for another 30 minutes to the top of King Kong Hill. Usually, the tour groups leave shortly after sunrise, and you'll get plenty of time to then enjoy the view all to yourself. When you're ready, make your way back to the town of Semoro Lawang. The hike down is quite nice as you will get a beautiful view of Mount Bromo the whole way. Once we're back at Semoro Lawang, we stop for a delicious breakfast before making our way to Bromo. The trailhead to Bromo is right next to the Semoro Inda Hotel. From here, you'll walk for another hour before reaching Bromo. The reason I said I was able to hike Bromo for free is because there's no pay station at any point on the trail if you walk by foot, whereas you will be charged a $15 to $20 entrance fee if you go by jeep with a tour. Once you get to the foot of Mount Bromo, you will be able to again hire a horse up to the mountain. However, hiking on Bromo was such a cool experience, as the unique landscape simply looks out of this world.
Oh my god, the sound is so loud. Or is that the motorbike? No, it's a volcano. Oh yeah.
Roaring sun.
Oh my god. Smells bad too. Oh my god. That's crazy. Wow. It's loud.
Once you get to the top of the crater, you can actually walk all the way around the volcano.
So the people I'm with, they're actually there. I'm just gonna wait for them here. I don't know, something about not having a railing and this volcano scares me. So I will stay where the railings are.
Mount Bromo is not only an active volcano, but it also has a rich cultural history. It's considered a sacred site by the locals. Every year, they hold a ceremony in which offerings of fruit, vegetables, and livestock are thrown into the crater of the volcano as a sign of respect. After hiking down the mountain, I caught a bus heading to Problingo at around noon. The bus will drop you off at the Problingo bus and train station, where you can continue your adventure to other parts of Indonesia. Thank you for joining me today. I'll see you soon.